All right, welcome back to build video number 7 on our Isuzu MPS truck. We are back from 2 years of traveling Oz, and this is, I think, this is our groove. We like this bit. This is the electrical system in here. So this is what's been running all of our stuff for 2 years, basically. So let's jump into it, Andrew. What have we got in here?
All right, so mainly 400 amps of lithium. There is 400 watts, there's 500 watts of solar. There's a flexible panel up there doing this thing. And then we've got a Redarc Manager 30. So you've got to remember this was 2 years ago this was built. Obviously there's a few new products come out now, but this has been rock solid. Redarc Manager 30, two BCDC Core 40s, a 3000 watt Redarc inverter, which is probably the thing you can mainly see. And then the old TVMS and then the new TVMS Rogue. The Rogue had just come out. I think this was one of the first robes in captivity when this got fitted. And then there's three Red Vision screens, one this side, one that side, and then one on the dash.
Okay, let's go into batteries. Why Invicta? Well, sorry, we used Invicta. So there's two 200 amp hour Invicta batteries in there. Why Invicta? Why did you choose 400 amp hours? Hit us with some of those details.
It's 400 amps, it fit well, kind of thing. Like it's all, so that's the cavity behind the fridge. So a bit of that as well. I would have done more. We considered stacking and going to 6 or 8. But to be honest, that was plenty in hindsight for the truck. Could add more in the van, but that was plenty for the truck.
Bluetooth capability, so if we were ever having issues with our Red Vision screens, we could jump into the app and use it then. If we were inside the van and we wanted to know what the truck was at, we could use the app. We didn't have to go and come out and look at the truck.
Yeah, the batteries.
Not much else to
it. Yeah, the batteries.
Amazing. All right, let's go next up, how we charge our lithium batteries. So let's start with the Redarc BCDCs.
No, go Manager. So the Manager 30 runs all the time. And that is just while we're driving the 30. And sorry, for those want techie questions, it's all 24 volt input. So because I use the Redarc, so straight up the truck's 24 volt truck, Mr. 12 volt number plates, I get the joke. I could just run 24 volts into all these charging bits. So the Manager 30 would just run all the time. That would handle while we're driving, and if we're at a caravan park under trees and we plugged in, then it would handle the plug-in charging. I think you can get away with a really low 240 volt charger because you're always overnight. So that was
so fine. We were 30 amps it's going in the Manager 30.
30 amps while you're driving.
AC charging though at caravan
Correct.
Parks.
Yeah. Then basically. We had the two Redarc cores. One of those cores, you'll notice, I don't know if you can see, but it's lit up. It's connected to a flexible panel I've got up on the rooftop tent. And then the cores really were, so they're switchable through the TVMS. That'll give you a close up. But the top two buttons were the two Redarc cores. And that gave me the ability. So the reason why I did that is because we also had a caravan with a giant system on the back as well, as you'd imagine. And so it got me to share the load. It was super sunny because we had 1600 watts on the van. It was super sunny and we're driving a while. I'd leave the van unplugged, the ando of the van unplugged, and because I knew the solar had topped that up, and then I could run 120 amps into this with the 30 and then the 240s, making 120.
And so that's all from the alternator, 120
all from the
amps.
120 amps, yep. From the alternator. Or if I really wanted the van to charge and I wasn't so concerned about the truck, I could obviously turn off the BCDCs, plug in the ando and send it all down to the van. So it just gave me a really good option for sharing the love around wherever I wanted it to go, depending on whatever. But it also meant like if we were somewhere and I wanted to get the truck up, I could just pump up the idle and pump 120 amps into it while it's idling.
So what was the solar going into? No solar controller, so where's the solar going
into? At the time, so the roof rack by All Terrain Warriors only fit the EnerDrive 200 watt high voltage panels. So they run a higher voltage, 37, something like that. At the time, Redarc didn't offer a solar solution for that. There was nothing that I could run that voltage in. So it was actually hidden down the bottom, a Morningstar solar regulator. They've since rectified that in their new range. Go Redarc. But there is a Morningstar solar controller down there. for the two panels on the all-terrain Warrior roof rack.
So in theory, if we were traveling, we could get the 120 plus whatever was coming in via the solar. So
yep.
We were actually possibly making more at some point in
time. Yeah, fair bit. Yeah, heaps.
And then we have a, it's not on this side, it's on the other side, a red input. So red Anderson plug input to plug a portable panel into. So we had issues with the second way we did our boat and the drawbar being over those Enerdrive panels. So if we were stationary and the boat was on, we needed to use a portable panel, and that was a purely designed by us option. And so was that all through the Morningstar as well?
No, that obviously goes through the Manager 30.
Cool.
And yeah, just the reason why we're so power hungry is because we're running a full freezer at sort of minus 18.
Fridge, and we've got a 130 fridge on the other side and a deep cycle.
Freezer. And so the freezer's the killer. Anybody, like when you're out there, if you're trying to run a freezer and a fridge, the freezer's the hungry thing because it's just grinding all the time.
Cool. All right, let's go into the inverter.
Yeah, inverter, 3000 watt red arc inverter, switched on by the TMS, by the Red Vision screens or the app, if you want to talk about the app. It's awesome, to be honest. We had no issues with it, and it, I think, probably had more grunt than the inverter in our caravan.
Yeah, correct. And so we would be able to run coffee machine and, like, you'd
anything.
Usually be able to run two appliances at once.
Yep.
Sometimes if it was like everything was going through its high cycle at once, it'd shut off,
yeah.
But it wasn't that.
Ronnie was pretty good at air fryer, coffee machine, induction cooktop all at once, but anyway.
So basically what the inverter does in layman's terms is it takes your 12 volt power stored in your battery and converts it into 240 volt power so you can run all your household appliances. So what I always say is this is the item that takes your camping to glamping because you're running your induction, your coffee machine, all of that sort of stuff off it. If you don't want any of those luxuries, you don't need an inverter, but we highly recommend it. It was also used for charging power tools, electric skateboards, I don't know, anything else. We would also move power between the truck and the van. We can get into that later on. So yeah, lots of different functions that we were using the inverter for. All right, so next up, let's go through all the switching. So it's the Red Arc TVMS and the Red Arc Rogue. Why have you used these, Andrew? What do they do?
Yeah, so the TVMS at the time was sort of the normal one that had been around for ages. It's really cool. It also does temperature and water tank inputs. We use the temperature inputs, so I've got them set up, one on the freezer, one on the fridge. And that was really cool actually, because it sort of meant while you're driving with the screen on the dash, you just knew nothing was going hot in the back. And then basically it gave me 20 channels of switching. So it could switch everything from, I don't know, the compressors, the...
Lights up here, lights in the rooftop tent,
yeah,
the BCDCs on and
BCDC's
off, inverter
on and
off.
Just...
We had the 240 plugs separate to the 12 volt.
Yep.
Everything was switched on and
yep.
off, lights. Any lights on the truck were through there as
yeah,
well?
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
Yeah.
Except
so
spotlights and stuff.
And so how many lots of switching channels between those two units did we have?
So 20. They're 10 each.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
And so that they're really cool. Like it made it, and it actually makes it really easy to wire because it means that I just got one data cable running all over the truck, to the dash, to these two screens. And back to those, all the power's there, and basically it just meant that everything runs back to there. So it really simplifies your wiring as well.
All right, while we're standing here, we're gonna run through the compressor side of things.
Okay.
Because it's nice and easy. Yep.
Yep, compressor. So these tires, like you're like 100 PSI and they're 37s. So it's pretty epic pumping them up. And we never, ever, ever got towed. We got definitely parked a lot on the beach, but I never got towed. And it's because it's all about tire pressures with these things. And we went every soft beach we managed to find. We decided it would be a great idea to go to the point and get stuck. So I had three ARB double pumpers in there. They were all running on the ARB pressure control app and into a airbag man tank. And it's like, just it all fit well in there. We'll shove our video guy in the hole to show you them. They're all tucked up behind the fridge canopy. And yeah, so
what was the attachment thing that you could do two tires at once?
I don't even have that on me. But basically, retractable air hose came out and we could just plug in two tires at once. I run different pressures front and rear, so the two was perfect, but it meant you could deflate, inflate the fronts and the rears, and pressure control app means you can just hit go, say 105 PSI, walk off, go do something else. When the compressor's shut down, then you know you're at that that PSI, so that was great.
And so just to give you an idea, I would, if we're coming off the beach or dirt roads or whatever, I would inflate the four caravan tyres, and at the same time Andrew would do the four truck tyres, and the volume size of these compared to the caravan is massive. So the yep. three double, people always ask why three, that's basically why.
So I'd go from like 30 to 105 where the van would be like, say, I don't know, 15 to 30,
yeah.
Like 18 to 30
yeah.
kind of thing,
so
totally different.
Super speedy. Andrew's yeah. an impatient person, hence we have three.
And three kids going, when are we going to
go? All right, let's roll into the Red Vision screen, because that is really what, this is all closed up. The Red Vision screen is all you use day to day as far as operating your electrical system. So let's roll through that.
Okay, so Red Vision screen, they want me to go through all the buttons. These top two are for the DC-DC, so I can turn each one on individually. Compressors. That was our Cell-Fi Go, we used that a bit. The fridge picture was, I was going to put a fridge in the center console, turned out we didn't need that, but that's power to the front of the truck. So that powered up, there's a mini inverter and all the USB sockets and everything in the front, which was cool. That is the lights inside, they're the roof, okay, so up on the roof rack, I did, there's lights on either side, so this is left and right, that's white, so left, yeah, white, these two are amber. That is a downlight, so I got underneath it. That was the inverter, so that was cool. That's internal lighting, that's water pump. That was powered to the rooftop tent. These two that are locked out are the freezer on one side and the fridge on the other. So through the Red Vision, you can just lock channels, and so you can't turn them off, basically, so I had them locked. The 12 volt one was all this sort of power all around the canopy. And oh, this was an idea that was awesome in theory, but didn't work so well. There is actually motion sensors on the canopy. And then, so that's motion sensors and that's lights on the roof. It did work pretty well. So you could just switch on the motion sensors and go to bed. And the idea was if something came around, everything would light up. But it turned out they're a bit sensitive with wind and stuff. And that's basically it. So this also then, while we're driving, you could see what was charging, obviously what percentage the battery was at. And yeah, you know, we'd get a 120 amps going in if everything was turned on. The 4 days, I always get asked about that. It continually calculates. So what it's basically saying is that this usage with this much battery power at this moment, if it stayed the same for 4 days, it would last 4 days. It recalculates constantly. So as the sun comes out, it'll probably change. And if we started the truck, it would change to charging and it would shorten then as well. Also while we're here, just 240 volt, obviously off the inverter. That was just an Ando output, probably never used it. USB-A, USB-C, we use that a fair bit. And these are all scattered around. These are the controllers for the hardcore lights. Bright, dull, like they were dimmable, and yellow, and then bright white kind of thing. This is this side, and the one on the other side is the other side, if that makes sense. I split the canopy up, so it was just the way we did it. But yeah, it was cool. That's about it, I think.
So inside the cab, we have an extra inverter. So it's an Enerdrive 600 watt. It was just what work sent over to us while we were traveling. We added an inverter in here so we could basically charge drones, charge laptops while we were driving. I would work a lot while we were driving. We also ran a Starlink modem off it sometimes when we were driving. So it was just a little bit easier. We didn't want to run 240 cable between the canopy and the truck just because there's a fair bit of movement when you're rolling along. So we just did a totally independent system that obviously runs off the battery. We've also got in the rear some charging points for the kids, so they've each got a USB-C, USB-A little charging port so they could run their devices and charge everything while we were in motion. And then also an extra charge point down in here. So that's pretty much it for the electrical inside the cab. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. As always, YouTube thinks you should watch this one here. The full MPS build series is down here. And stay tuned, because next week we are going to take you through the rear air conditioning system that we have installed in our Isuzu truck.